We are glad you're here. Excuse me. Let us now stand and greet each other in some safe manner. I'm glad the scythe is gone because people could lose limbs. Excellent timing. I was about to say, y'all sit down. Uh-oh, hand up.
I got a request on Facebook to be Clinton Quinn's friend. He did not send it. He's been hacked. So if anybody else here got it, please don't friend him. On Facebook.
Okay, those things go around all the time. Exactly. Let us now turn our hearts and our minds toward God in worship.
test to being a liturgist is a fulfilling job. It's something fun. Y'all should try it. You don't have to sing a solo introit to be the liturgist. It just worked out that way today. Our choir director is out of town, so I volunteered. Please stand and join with me in the call to worship. We seek as pilgrims on a journey of faith.
We are seeking the awareness of God's presence as we travel on.
We come seeking light for our darkness, strength in our weakness.
Shine in our hearts, O God, with the light of your love. May your presence known through Jesus the Christ.
Amen. And my God will fully satisfy every need of yours, according to his riches in glory in Christ Jesus. open my eyes that I may see glimpses of truth thou hast for me. Place in my hand the wonderful key that shall unclasp and set me free. Silently now I wait for thee. Ready, my God, thy will to see. Open my eyes, illumine me, Spirit divine. Open my ears that I may hear voices of truth thou sendest clear. And while the wave notes fall on my ear, everything false will disappear. Silently now I wait for thee. Ready, my God, thy will to see. Open my ears, illumine me, Spirit divine. Open my mouth and let gladly the warm truth everywhere. Open my heart and let me prepare love with thy children thus to share. Silently now I wait for thee. Ready, my God, thy will to see. Open my heart, illumine me.
Now I would like to invite any children or youth we have with us to come and join me on the front steps of the chancel for a few moments. Good morning. How are you guys today? Good. Excellent. Who knows what today is? Forgot to read the bulletin, didn't you? Who knows what today is? The 22nd Sunday after Pentecost. Don't have to worry. It'll be a few more weeks and we'll be done with this Pentecost thing. Until Pentecost next year. Who knows what day Pentecost is on next year? Ooh, excellent answer. Excellent answer. Yes, it will be on Sunday. As far as the date, I don't know. Go look at a calendar before I don't know. All right. I got something in the bag to share with you. What is this? Suspenders. Not quite. See if I can figure out how it works. Goes this way, like this, and I stick my injured arm in here. Didn't know I had an injured arm, did you? Well, you do now. I don't really, but at one time I did. Excellent, excellent. Now it's your turn. Ooh, ah, yeah. I'm going to trip over this if I don't move it. Okay, why do I have this? Was that? Your arm is sprained, you got hurt. Sometimes if you're waiting for surgery on your broken arm, they would do this. That happened to me once. You get a sling, and it helps because you don't have to hold it up. You don't have to put it in a position where it would really, really hurt. So you leave it this way. Because it helps doctors heal us, right? It helps our body to heal. What about when there's something wrong with our soul? What about when there's something wrong with the way we feel other than physically? Maybe we're upset about something. What helps us heal? I stumped you, didn't I? That's all right. Sometimes what helps us heal is talking to another person about it, talking to somebody in our family. Sometimes our families are the reason we're upset, so we go talk to friends, right? We got all these people out here, all these people. Sometimes when something's upsetting us, we can go to church and talk to somebody at church about it, talk to a Sunday school teacher or a youth person or the pastor or even somebody who doesn't have one of those roles but still might be able to help, right? So that's what we need to do. Jesus said that we're to do the things that he did. What did he do? Well, he walked on water. That one's probably pretty hard for us to do. According to the Bible, he did that. He helped heal people. He helped feed people. He helped, that's the story we heard, open my eyes that I may see, because the scripture for today in church is going to be the healing of a blind person, okay? So, when we're hurt, we go to the doctor, we get things like this that help us heal. Band-aids, you probably have those at home. They help you heal, they cover up your cut so it doesn't get dirt in it, right? Helps it heal. But for healing of our soul and our person, sometimes we just need to turn to the church, to the Bible. We can read stories in the Bible that'll help us understand a little better, all right? Yeah, we're nodding, sort of. And we're also smiling. I can tell you're laughing. You're laughing underneath that mask. I can tell. Your eyes are showing that you're smiling. That's good. That's good. Somebody told me I had to smile with my eyes because we're all wearing these masks. How many of you have heard that? Learn to smile with your eyes. I don't know what that looks like, but we can tell when somebody's doing it, huh? All right. So, let's have our prayer. Dear God, we thank you for trained people who are able to help us when something hurts us physically. We thank you for people who are trained to help us when something hurts us emotionally. We thank you for the church, for friends, for family, for the Bible, and for your love. Amen. Okay, thank you very much. You may go to Sunday school.
Stand if you are able and join in the statement of faith. We believe that God, the Creator and Lord of this universe, knows and cares for every person. We believe that God is made real to us today through the Scriptures, through Jesus Christ, and through the lives of holy persons. We believe that God's Spirit is available every moment to convict us of our selfish ways and to enable us to rise above ourselves into a Christ-like life. We believe that God's mission for us is to minister in Christ's name and to share God's love, justice, and healing with all people. Amen. Standard Version of the Bible, the Gospel of Mark, chapter 10, verses 46 through 52. They came to Jericho. As he and his disciples and a large crowd were leaving Jericho, Bartimaeus, son of Timaeus, a blind beggar, was sitting by the roadside. When he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to shout and say, "Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me." Many sternly ordered him to be quiet, but he cried out even more loudly, "Son of David, have mercy on me." Jesus stood still and said, "Call him here." And they called the blind man, saying to him, "Take heart, get up, he is calling you." So throwing off his cloak, he sprang up and came to Jesus. Then Jesus said to him, "What do you want me to do for you?" The blind man said to him, "My teacher, let me see again." Jesus said to him, "Go, your faith has made you well." Immediately he regained his sight and followed him on his way. This ends the reading of today's holy word. Thanks be to God.
Prayer, and as we have done for a number of weeks, we continue to pray for two of the other churches in our district, in the South District of the California Pacific Annual Conference. And today we are lifting up Irvine University United Methodist Church and their pastors Kathy Kapp and Brandon Wan, and the Chapel of the Hill in Descanso and their pastor Julie Elkins. So let us remember these congregations and their pastors in our prayers. In addition, I would lift up the family of Bill Carpenter, who passed away this past week. And having said that, I would like to let everyone know that Mava, his spouse, would like some privacy and some time at this point. So I would ask all of you to respect her wishes. She also wanted folks to know that Bill died, and before he died, he contracted COVID-19, and that after he died, Mava tested positive for COVID-19. So please remember the Carpenter family in your prayers. And let us begin now with silence as we remember this concern, these concerns, the churches, the Carpenter family, as well as any that we might hold in our hearts. Let us pray. Gracious God, you have reached out to us in love. Help us in love to reach back toward you. We clamor after you, seeking relief from our ills and misfortunes, hoping for your healing, begging for your soothing balm. Give us this, grant us that, we say to you in our prayers. Perhaps it is your generosity toward us that leads us to pray in this way. You have not sent us away empty, but in countless acts of mercy, you have reached out to us and given us what we needed. Just now, we are bold to ask for one more divine gift, the gift of grace to follow you, the gift to have our eyes wrenched off of ourselves with our needs and moved toward the needs of others, the gift to learn the joy that comes to us through service to you and your kingdom, the gift to have the courage to be true to your way, even when it is not the world's way. Grant us grace to follow. This we ask and pray, remembering the one who came to heal, to teach, and to serve, even Jesus our Christ, who taught us to pray, saying, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen." Gracious and loving God, often we are surprised and amazed by the fact that you have chosen the likes of us to do your work. But we do believe that we have been called, and that we are your helpers, and that we join in your creative spirit, enabling others to live in justice and peace and mercy. We pray now that every act of generosity in this offering be guided by your strong spirit. Amen. Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditation